So there's a few things with multiplayer, because we've designed the game multiplayer first from the beginning. And, you know, basically the single player is kind of a shard of the multiplayer. So any mission, we designed a multiplayer game, and then we said that any mission, any game type, and also the campaign, you can play in single player if you want, but it's predominantly multiplayer. And there's a number of things there. One is we've got up to 12 players in a match. So you get these, you know, huge, colossal battles. The other one is we've got a persistent campaign. So you actually have World War III taking place across 40 territories in America, Europe, Russia. But each of those territories, you know, wherever the front line is along those battlefields, it's not just going to be a straight conquest. You'll get a different battle if the front line is in enemy territory and, you know, air support's being cut off, and it's the third battle on the same territory, so all the landscape's all devastated and destroyed. So it's a very, you know, dynamic kind of campaign. We've got tournament support built in. We've got full clan support, clan leaderboards. The other thing we've done, we've got quite a cool for clans and teams, is a connection between the website and the game. So you can go and view the state of the multiplayer campaign on the web. We've also got like a battle planner, like it's basically a whiteboard you can use online with your clan to plan battles and tactics. And then you can look at and view those battle plans in-game over live. You can view replays in the game from the top players on the leaderboard at the end of the week. So we attach the replays of their matches. So we've really, you know, done a lot for the multiplayer side of the game.
In a 12-player game, the EndWar stage has to be totally crazy. Have you played a lot of those kind of games, and how will those look like?
Actually, for the multiplayer games, we've also taken a model that's a bit inspired by sports games. So if you've got six players on a side, you can have 600 units, 600 soldiers, but they're organized into their platoons, companies, etc. And then we split control of the army. So if there's 18 platoons, we've got, you know, we could have three each, for example. And then the other thing which we do with that, and another key feature of the multiplayer, is your army, which you take online, every battle they survive, every unit gets experience. Between battles you can buy upgrades. We've got about 150 upgrades for each faction. So we can each bring our own units into the battle. So if I've maxed out, I've got these really cool helicopter gunships, really high experience, I can bring them. If you've got a really upgraded, you know, sniper unit with great experience, you can bring that. So we can all specialize and basically work together as a team, depending on what our units, how our army's been built up.
All right, so it really, really emphasizes specializing and getting good at one part of the game and then combining with other players?
Yeah, like the units are almost modeled on the way you kind of have classes in a RPG, you know? Like fighters in an RPG are called tanks for a reason and so on. So, you know, support units, stealthy units, and so on. So by specializing in a particular role, you can really work together effectively as a team.
It's a little bit like playing Battlefield or something like that in the multiplayer, would you say?
Yeah, I think you know, role-playing games like World of Warcraft, you know, you can see it in like enemy territory, Quake Wars, you know, that idea of sort of team play and specialization and the whole team being better when everyone works together, it works as well in our game, yeah.
So when you're playing yourself in a 12-player multiplayer map, what kind of role do you take, and what kind of units do you like to play around with most?
Actually, I just love the gunships, just because they're sort of like, from doing Rome, they're kind of the light cavalry, so they're fast, so you can really get in, hit, run, pull out, get in, hit and run. And the special weapons, they've got access to a whole, like, you've got the big chain guns, big heavy machine guns mounted on the front. They've got their rockets, and then they've got like non-line of sight missiles. So you can sort of park yourself and launch these sort of precision missile strikes across the battlefield. It's sort of like having an airborne sniper. So yeah, they're really cool.
What games have you been most excited about here in Leipzig this year?
The ones I really look forward to seeing, Call of Duty, Modern Warfare. I think in a way, you know, what the way they're moving away from World War II and the way they're addressing the intensity and the scale and, you know, the weapons of the modern battlefield, I think sort of has something in common with what we're trying to do. I was really hoping to see Mass Effect, but I haven't seen that. I'm really looking forward to that.
You haven't gotten in on that? Oh, I saw it yesterday.
Oh, yeah.
But it's the same demo as on E3, so if you've seen that...
Oh, I missed E3 as well. I'm going to have to get a journalist badge, I think. And Rock Band just looks awesome. That looks so fun. That's the first game ever, you know, that I can play with my wife. So basically, she can play SingStar and I'm playing Guitar Hero. Same time, really cool.
Who's manning the drum?
Yeah, I don't know. I'm sure we'll find someone. Maybe my daughter. I just had one.
All right, so thank you very much for your time.
Thanks a lot.